friends, I'm recording this video on the same topic, Indian links and guest house. Some posted it's not edible or whatever. Very simple, forget about ES, forget about H1B, forget about all these guest houses. Okay, now what I'm speaking is rights of H1Bs. Law, what is there in the H1B book rule. I'm not an attorney, okay? I'm just sharing my experience. People who are writing filthy to me or negative, they are either, doesn't matter what visa you have, man. I did not marry H1B visa, right? You did not marry F1 visa, OPT card. It's only a temporary thing. Everybody will die on this planet one day, okay? So don't assume that Kumar is against F1, H1 like that. So somebody who doesn't understand truth or who doesn't understand basic common sense, write like that. Okay, point one clear. Point two, for example, take in India or any Asian nations where currency is Indian rupees, right? INR. I pick up a boy or a girl. I will say 5,000 Indian rupees I will give you per month. Okay, I have a company, it may be any company, software industry company, right? Like what we generally mention, outsourcing companies. So I will offer him 5,000 INR, Indian rupees, per month. Then 12 months, it would be 60,000 rupees, right? Matter is clear. But I offer him or her on a paper or offer letter, but I don't offer. I will put them in a guest house for 6 months. I don't pay. So what I'm doing, I'm violating the rule, right? Offer letter. So offer letter is fake. After 6 months, he or she get a client project. So I ask them to search for their own project. So they search some. 5,000 rupees I give. For 6 months I don't give. In 6 months I ask you get a project. In 6 months I ask you get a project. Get a project where the client pay 20,000 rupees per month. Okay? So that as an employer I take 5,000 rupees. That, and I will insert one more layer, or you, when you search for client project, there are illegal names, or one prime vendor and the other one is illegal. So they also take money. So but I pay 5,000 rupees. So like that you work for 4 months, project over. So next 2 months, no project, no guest house. Because first time you stay, only when you are virgin, you stay in the guest house. That means, don't misunderstand. When you fresh you come to America. Second time, no guest house. Whether you come on H1B from India or F1 from university. Now come to the America. So if that example is not clear, then I can't help you. You have to learn basics, go to elementary school. If that example is clear, take the same example, put it in America. Instead of Indian employers, we call Indian names. People call employers, I don't really understand, it is called the H1B petition. So once that is done, petitioner, instead of Indian rupees, you put dollars, $5,000 in month. Offer letter speaks $60,000, but like I said, 6 months you stay in guest house. That is illegal and crime as per USCIS. Whether you have project or not, employer must pay. That is the rule number one. Rule number two, employer must get a project. That is failed. The employees search for the project, but they take the commission. Failed rule number two. Next, rule number three. The prime vendor inside illegal layer, the outsourcing companies or some American companies, and illegal, sometimes H1B petitioner insert illegal layer, spouse company, brother's company, wife or somebody's company, to post that $45. You search a project, $100 plus hourly billing, but employer takes a cut, illegal layer takes a cut, and then they throw some peanuts, very less money in sense, and they pay $25 for H1Bs. But OPTs, there is no minimum wage, so they pay $10 or some they work for free for experience. So what do you call all this? It's a pimping greaser. They should know the basic rules. They are violating these rules. Nobody is coming and complaining. Even if you complain, the Department of Labor can add, unless you show your bank statement, prove that your employer is being kind here. But everybody loves dollars and green cards. So who will come and prove, right? Because you all want dollars. Matter is clear. So when employer is paying $5,000 a month, I will stay in a hotel where $100, $30, whatever the room rent. I don't need to stay in the guest house. They are not paying salaries. That's why they are putting in guest house. 20 members, 50 members in one room, one bedroom or one bath apartment, whatever. This crime. When I say this, people are crying. Why don't you understand the basics? When you give an offer letter, why do you need a guest house accommodation? That means offer letter is fake. Now it is clear, right? There are two kinds of salaries maintained by Indian Inc. One is offer letter paper, that is to bluff the USCIS, bluff the US consulates in India, and bluff everyone, including you. That is employee. And the second salary is whatever the billing rate you get, but they pay $25. But prevailing wage in New York cities like New York is $45 an hour for H1B. But vendors take $45 per hour cut and they pay it to employer, and employer take $15. So everybody is making prevailing wages here. Anybody between the prime vendor and H1B petitioner is illegal, unethical, unlawful. He is a criminal man. But to slap him, you are doing a country like USA, taking use cut, and sometimes the hiring managers, for example, wherever Indian hiring managers are there, no matter what caste it is, religion, reason of Indian, he takes $10 a cut. Somebody asked me, how does Americans take? Americans not all are corrupted, but who are corrupted, they also take money. I can't tell free of cost to you. You have to investigate like what I'm doing. They don't take like Indians, because Indian hiring managers, they want sex, because men is not exempted from sex, whiskey, wine or women, beer, and then money, right? So these three, you can buy any Indians. You cannot buy every American. Understand? He insert a layer, he takes $10 a cut. So you petition insert a layer, he takes a $10 cut. And then prime vendor, like this outsourcing companies, they insert a layer, they also take a $40 cut. So overall, there are five layers. This one takes this much cut. Then how does a H1B live with family? If I read this, somebody saying, you are living with the family, you are old, what is this? You are not supposed to breaking all rules, man. EEOC. There is no age discrimination, gender discrimination, any racial discrimination in America. You studied MS here, you are working on H1B or whatever the visa, and you are asking about my age, in what way you are concerned. That means you don't really understand the basic rules of American H1B, right? H1B is an employment there. Indians made this as an infiltration. And when I say share and care, somebody wrote, Kumar is communist. Americans and Indians also wrote. What is communist? Share and care is communist. Then loot and remit is Indian. What are you writing, guys, man? I don't really understand. You have to understand the basic rules. 10th standard knowledge is enough, man, to do attorney's job here. I'm not insulting anybody, but Indian attorneys are also corrupted. So they are colluded with a criminal called willful violator. We call employer, but it's a petition. So they take use cut, they take money, they hide, they hold the green card papers, they take $25 for green card. What are all you guys are doing? See, guest house, why do you need a guest house? That means you are not paying salary to your employees, but you are paying some salary bluff to USCIS. Understand now? If America ride every Indian Inc. business house, every Indian's house, every Indian Inc. guest house, then gone. Thanks for watching this
video. That is the end chapter of H1B.
I don't care about my haters, but those who understand, USCIS source is a website. Those who don't understand, they are writing nonsense. So if you are educated, if you are when I'm speaking about rights and you are commenting, criticizing me, then probably you might be doing crime in America. This is not India, you can't do like that. When I say that, somebody wrote a comment also. Yes, in India, MLAs, MPs, politicians, lawmakers are fleeing in America, right? What are you guys are doing? You write an email to Vijay Mallya, not to Kumar. Or you comment to him, if you have guts, he'll slap on your face, address escalation. You are not paying salary means you put them in the guest house. You put them in the guest house means you do prostitution, you do anything with them. When I say prostitution, somebody wrote, what is this? Yes, whatever I am speaking is only just 1% of this, what you call, tip of the iceberg. Thank you.
See, that is the end of the H-1B. I mean, unless America ride, they will not come to know what's happening in Indian rings and behind the scenes, because victims are nexus with accused. Thank you for watching this video.